Dear students, so today we are discussing or today we are conducting experiment on photoelasticity of a circular disc under compression. So the main aim of the experiment is to determine the model fringe constant of a photoelastic material subjected to diametrical compression. So before going to the experiment, first of all, we have to know what is meant by photoelasticity. Photoelasticity is the phenomenon of finding whatever the changes, that is like stress distribution in a photoelastic materials. So today we will see that how we are going to find out the stress distribution across the photoelastic material with the help of a circular disc under compression with a polariscope setup. So what are the apparatus required here? Polariscope setup and the photoelastic material. This is the sketch or the graphical representation of the setup. So this left end shows that this is a frame which has the counterweight, and this is the hinged point that is called as a fulcrum, and this is the circular polariscope setup which includes polarizer, analyzer as well as the specimen, and the right end side we are going to apply the load. So this is the simple sketch or the graphical representation of polariscope setup. For this experiment, we have to conduct some, we have to come to know, these are the some observations we have to observe here. First one is, this is the, before that I am going to show you, this is the specimen or a model which we are going to conduct the experiment. This is the material which is made up of resin and epoxy, that is nothing but the photoelastic material. This is used for different applications like medical applications and etc. See, it has a specific diameter here. For that you have to take down that reading, the diameter of the model, or that is the diameter of the specimen D, and the thickness of the specimen or the model T, which is there in mm, and you have to note down the length from a fulcrum point to the load, that is L, it is in centimeter, and length from a fulcrum point to the specimen or a model, which is taken as a L1, in centimeter. So ratios of these two, that is R is equals to L by L1, which is equals to, it comes some value which will be used later for finding the fringe constant value of a photoelastic material. This is the tabular column for a particular experiment. So I will explain the complete procedure how to conduct the experiment. Before that, just note down the tabular column, which includes the fringe order and how much load you are going to apply. So we are going to apply it in terms of kg, then you have to convert it into Newton, and you have to calculate the effective load, that is P, which is equals to the net load into the ratios of the fringe load to the fulcrum point, that is R. Then slope, that is delta P divided by delta N. You are getting this from the graph. And at the end, you are going to find out what is the material fringe constant F sigma, that is a Newton per mm per fringe. This will indicates that the last column, that is a material fringe constant F sigma, will gives you how much stress distribution across the photoelastic material will shows here. These are the some formulae which will be used in the particular experiment. First one is a weight, that is W, which is given as M into G. Then effective load P, which is equals to W into R. Then delta P by delta N, that is slope, you are getting this from the particular graph according to your values. Then you are going to find out material fringe constant. The main aim of the experiment is to find out the material fringe constant F sigma, which is given as 8 divided by pi d, which is into p by n. So in summarize, 8p divided by pi d, and the values from the slope, which is we are getting from the graph. So this is the graphical representation of a graph, which gives you the vertical and horizontal axis, that is y and x axis. Y axis will gives you a load in terms of Newton, and x axis will gives you fringe in Newton per mm or in numbers. So the delta p and delta n, that is slope of this, the particular values, from the particular values you are going to find out delta p by delta n. So this value you are going to introduce to find out material fringe constant, that is F sigma. Okay, delta p by delta n, you are going to put the values from a graph and in order to find out the material fringe constant F sigma. So now I am going to explain the complete setup of polariscope experiment. The first one is the diffuse light polariscope, which will give you monochromatic light, and after that there will be two quarter wave plates are there. The first quarter wave plates, which will give you polarizer and a beam with a fulcrum point. At the left hand will have a counterweight here, and after that the second quarter wave plate and the analyzer. And the right part, which will give you a pan which carries the load. We are going to fix the model or a specimen under compression with a plane specific model or with a hole, and as well as the horizontal or the rectangular specimen. Once you switch on the light and you have to fix the specimen in a rectangular beam, so once the load is applied at the right hand pan, so we here we are putting 3 kg of weight. Due to this load, this beam is trying to get a load on this specimen, which will give you which will generate the fringes. So as shown here, so this is now under compression, because this is the beam which is carrying the load, which is acting on this specific material. Okay, so due to this load, this will generate the fringes here. So that is nothing but the stress effect here. The stress is generating, or the stress is induced in a photoelastic material. So here the fringe is generated here one. So you can observe here, this is the first fringe which is generated here for the application of a 3 kg load. Now I am going to change the load, that means I am going to increase the load in order to get the higher fringe order. So here for 3 kg, as we observed, only one fringe is generated. Now we are applying another load here, so another 1 kg is increased here. So as you observed here, so first fringe is already where we got this for 3 kg of load. Now I have increased 1 kg of load. So now complete one fringe is generated, and second fringe is also generated here. The third fringe is now begin to start now here. So as you observed here, first fringe and second fringe you can clearly observe for the particular 4 kg of load. Now further increasing the load, the fringe value changes here. At this point you can observe here the first fringe, second fringe and the third fringe. So clearly you can observe and you can count the fringes here, even in the the lower point here, the first fringe and the second fringe and the third fringe for the application of 5 kg of load here. And further increasing the load, you are getting the fringe order, it keep on changing, and another 1 kg of load is increased. So here, first fringe, second, 3 and 4 to begin here. 4 fringe order is there. So you have to note down in a tabular column for the particular application of a load, what is the fringe number you are getting. For example, for the 3 kg of load, you may get only 1 fringe. Okay. For the application of 5 kg load, you may get 2 fringes here. This is the procedure you have to follow. That means keep on increasing the load, and with respect to that, you have to observe the specimen for that particular application of a load, how much fringes are generated. So this fringe generates, which is on the photoelastic material, will gives you stress distribution. This is how you are going to find out stress distribution in a photoelastic material. That means fringe constant F sigma with the help of the formula. So as we discussed, 8P divided by pi D, that is a slope, that is delta P by delta N.